Yo, what is up everyone? Today we're gonna come straight into this video with a banger tutorial. We're gonna be working in Photoshop and DaVinci Resolve. So in Photoshop we're gonna create this metallic looking logo. In DaVinci Resolve we're gonna do a 3D logo rotate. Play the clip. So now that you guys see what you're gonna be learning today, we're gonna get straight into this video and I'm gonna head into Photoshop right now. So I actually found a Photoshop tutorial on how to do this, so I'm gonna briefly go over it, but I'm gonna link the video that I found. It's way more in detailed. I am nowhere skilled as much as this guy, but if you just follow along with his video, you'll be able to get to where I'm at, but I'm gonna basically just go over the basics and maybe you can get it from my tutorial, but if not, his is way more in depth. I really assure you that you should go down and watch his. But anyways, let's get back to it. Okay, so in here, you're gonna wanna translate your background image from white to black, preferably, and then you're basically just gonna come up here, you're gonna grab a text layer, and as my logo I just did DZKZ, and this is the font I will be using. This is my company's font. I'm gonna put this up to about 150, maybe even 250 for now. We're gonna come up here, we're gonna resize this to where I want it. Right there, there's some lines, so you just resize it. And we're gonna hit convert to a smart object. So then you should get this little arrow down here. We're gonna double click and hit blending options. Now we're gonna turn on bevel, and with it selected, we're basically just gonna come over here and mess with all of these settings. So you can honestly kind of just mess with what you want it to look like. If you want like this effect, you could do that. If you wanna soften it up, you can. If you wanna make it really straight edges, totally up to you. And then this is a big one, if you mess with this angle, you can kind of get a cooler looking effect depending on how you do your angle. But we'll mess with that in a bit. Under this drop down menu, you can kind of mess with the different things, and kind of just really just mess around with what you think looks best. I'm gonna keep the shadow at 42. Then under inner shadow, we're just gonna hit that, come over here, and I'm just gonna bring up the size a little bit. So now I kind of have something like this once I'm done. Now essentially what I did here is I added a curve. This is before curves and this is after curves. You could take a look at my graph up here and kind of how I did it. You basically just fuck with it until you think it looks good, honestly. Like I said, more in-depth tutorial version down below. I'll link the guy's description down there. And then what really brings it all together is this gradient map. So I'll show you guys what I did here. Essentially what you're doing is just adding a color. So you would double click this and add the color that you want. And then on this side, you kind of double click and add it what color you want. And then you just hit okay, simple as that. Now we're gonna make a gradient map merge. So holding down the gradient map curves and the group layer we made for our text, you're gonna group them. Now this is really gonna bring it together. So it's gonna put it up top right here. We're gonna go to filter and hit blur and do Gaussian blur. Now I'm gonna put it at 20 and just hit okay. Now you should have something like this. This is the before and the after. I really like how it brings it all together. As you can see, we're already looking 10 times better. Now something I did to spice it up a little bit was add this spark. I'll show you guys how to do that. Come down here to the polygon tool and change this to 4 and hit this gear button right here. Copy all these settings right here. Once you have all those settings copied, you should be able to just drag down and create this looking star effect. And once you think you have it like nicely done, we're essentially going to grab, we're gonna add another layer. We're gonna come to the brush, double click, make sure you're on soft round, click right in the middle, just like that. And then we're gonna merge those two. So once we have it merged, we're gonna do the same thing. You're gonna come to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and you're gonna also put 20 as this one as well. This will just make it look all better. Now again, we're gonna grab all the sparks and all of these layers right here, and we're gonna double click and merge them. So as you can see, this is my merge layer. This is the before and after. All we did was we came here, went to filter, blur, and then applied some Gaussian blur. Now really to tie this all together, what we did was we added a gradient map, which is super simple. So under here, you won't have these effects labeled, obviously. So under here, you'll just hit effects, and under here, you're gonna look for the gradient overlay. Click the gradient overlay. You should get something like this, kind of double click it and really just mess with it. Something I recommend you do is mess with this angle because it'll really bring it all together. But that's what we did to add and really bring it together. And then one last thing that we did was we're gonna add some noise. So as you can see here, the reason why this brings it all together is, as you can see, there's no noise. So in his video, he actually applied noise above his logo. Personally, I didn't like that. I applied one above it, but I put it at 30% opacity so that you didn't really have, you couldn't really notice it too much. And then for the layer, I put it under everything, under all my text. I just put it above my background layer. Then I put the one that's higher. So as you can see, it really brings it all together. Now you can see the noise, and essentially what you did here was for the grain, we put it at 80% opacity, which really brings the whole thing together. So once you have this as your logo, believe it or not, you're actually gonna take off all of the background, so the noise. And once you have the noise like this, and you have a transparency background, we're gonna go file and export it. Once you have it exported, now we're gonna hop into DaVinci Resolve. So now we're in DaVinci Resolve. This is essentially what I created, and this is what my workflow is looking like. I have a couple of sound effects, and then I have a gust of wind, and I kind of have it bouncing up and down. And then I also have a reflective. So as you can see, when it passes by right here, you see that reflective, and I have it going by decently slow. So now I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like after we put together a bunch of compound clips. This is our Fusion page. So we're dragged an adjustment clip into our thing. So you come in here, you have a media one. We're just gonna disconnect it, delete, grab our node, that our logo that we just exported. Once you have it exported into here, just connect it to your media one out. Now that you see you have your logo, now we're gonna get straight to business. So with your media two selected, we're just gonna do shift space and do an image plane 3D, then a shift space and duplicate 3D, then shift space again, we're gonna do transform 3D, shift space, render 3D. Now we're gonna just connect this output to the media out. Now we're gonna have our logo pop up. So now essentially to get two views, you have to hit this split button right here. So now we essentially get two windows. So for our second one, we're gonna bring in the 3D. So under duplicate, we're just gonna hit two. So once you have two separate windows, enable to move this 3D around. We're actually just gonna deselect this just because I don't need it as of now. And to roll this around, you're just gonna hit shift and move your mouse around, and you're able to see what you're looking at. Now, an important step is under render. Under this software render, we're just gonna hit hardware render. This will make the render process way smoother in the long run. So under duplicate 3D1, we're gonna come under the translation, and under Z offset, we're gonna hit -0.001. Now that is really important. Just make sure that you don't forget that step. And then now essentially under copies, we're just gonna hit 100 copies. And now that you can see our 3D layer is coming together nice and smoothly, as you can see. So really, in all honesty, you could stop right here and animate your thing, which I will teach you in just a second. So under the transform, I'm just gonna come under here, and I'm just gonna make sure that the size is all looking good. I kinda want it like, you know, 0.9-ish, and we'll just keep it at there for now. So now we're gonna get into the animating. We're gonna do this all under the transform node right now. No crazy animations. In my video, clearly all you saw was it spinning. So now we're going to just animate that really quickly. Under the rotation and under Y, we're gonna come under frame zero. We're just gonna hit a keyframe, and we're gonna come all the way to the end of the adjustment clip and rotate it whatever way you want, but do it how many twists you want. So say you want just three twists, then I would do one more. Now this is the important part, you wanna make sure it's centered. So you just have to know your measures, it's simple math. So for this one, it would just be 720, and now it's straight again. So now if we view it, now you can see we have a rotating logo already, and you could leave it here, honestly. If you want to, you can come into your spline and check mark this, hit zoom to fit, and highlight them all, hit S, and bring this down like this. So it would move really slow, and then it would pick up. So this is an option that you could do, just like that, or you could even just smooth it out just like this and kind of just do that like that. But my personal preference is literally just a straight line on the graph. You guys can do anything you want, but this is my personal preference. Now that I have a rotating image, what we're gonna do is we're gonna head back to the edit page, and essentially what you need to do, so in order for it to not look so stoppy, you wanna look like one motion, we're gonna take about a frame or two off, so it's kind of like that. We're gonna clip it. So once you clipped off a frame or two off the end of the clip, we're gonna hit option, and we're just gonna duplicate this over to the next one and just do that over and over again. So now, as you can see, there's just a smooth motion. between all the clips. Now you can't even tell there's a stop, but if there was, you could notice a stop in it, and you kind of, you don't want that. So now once you have this complete, you're gonna highlight all of them and you're gonna make a new compound clip. By that you double click and you create a new compound clip. So in this new compound clip, essentially what I did was I took the first frame, I'm gonna hit option and scroll up. We're actually just gonna, while this first frame is right here facing forward, we're gonna double click, we're gonna hit change speed, and we're gonna hit freeze frame and hit change. So now that you can see there's a compound clip too and it's frozen, now it's just one clip. I'm gonna go around 15 frames and chop it up. So now I have 15 frames of a frozen screen of my logo, and then obviously then it would start rotating. So essentially what we're gonna do is now we're gonna put this to the front like so. And now that you can see, we have a frozen frame and then it starts rotating. Now here's the sauce. Under this new compound clip, we're gonna go to the Fusion page. Now under here, we're gonna hit a transform node. At frame zero, we're gonna take our Y and take this down. We're gonna hit a keyframe and go all the way to the beginning and hit it back to 0.5. Come under the spline, check mark this, zoom to fit, hold it like this, highlight all of them, hit S, and I'm just gonna smooth it out like this. Last thing, you're gonna come up to the settings to the top right and hit use motion blur. I like to use it exactly how it is. So now we have an animation up into a 3D logo, just like that. So now we're gonna spice it up a little bit. So under our layer, when we export it as a transparent file, we did that for a reason, because we only want to spin the logo and we don't want the background spinning, because that wouldn't make any sense. So now, as you can see, if we apply our background gradient that we made in previous, now essentially we're gonna do is just take off everything except for the gradient. So we're gonna do the exact opposite of what we did before. So now that we have everything off and we have our gradient applied, now we're gonna come up here to file and export it, and export as a quick PNG. Now, once you have it exported, what you need to do is highlight both of these and create another compound clip, because we don't want it messy in our final timeline. So in our final timeline, now we have an animation up and it kind of spins around like this. As you can see from the first video I showed you guys, there is sound effects. You can do whatever you want. Add any sound effects you want. I encourage you on sound effects to make it look better. Now under here, we're gonna import our background. And with our background, we're gonna place it underneath our clip, and we're gonna just size this down, and I'm gonna hit 90, and I'm gonna size it back up, because that's how I personally want it, just like that. And now, the background on the back, now it looks exactly like the logo, but it's just an animation instead of a logo. So now as you can see, it animates up and it spins around just like that. Now guys, I hope you enjoyed that banger video. Let me know down below if you want more Fusion-like videos, because I am just now getting into Fusion. I'm getting into it, I really like it. It's super cool things to learn in Fusion, and I think it's really cool. I would love for you guys to join my free Discord full of editors, and it's called Editing Sauce. It's the first link down below. It would be great if you could send me the 3D logo that you made off of the video. That would be amazing, and if it looks like mine, then great. If you changed it up a little bit, then great. There is over 200 members. Actually, I think it's almost 300 members now, but don't forget to go join that. It's completely free. I don't see why you wouldn't, because you can learn a lot through a lot of people who are in the community. Like I said again, it's completely free, so why wouldn't you join it? All right, I'm out of here, guys. Leave a like and subscribe down below, and I'll catch y'all later.